Hey, I'm Bill Jelen from MrExcel.com, and I've got a cool Excel tip for you today.
Hey, this is Mike Girvin at ExcelIsFun on YouTube, and I have a different way to do that.
Excel gurus, which one shall I choose?
Hey, welcome back. It is another Dueling Excel podcast. I'm Bill Jelen from Mr. Excel. Mike Girvin from ExcelIsFun is going to be joining us, and you are going to learn so much today. The question, how do we do a picture lookup? So we choose a value, and depending on which value we choose, the picture changes. Now, Mike and I have dramatically different ways of doing this. I'm going to show you how I set this up, and then we'll throw it over to Mike. And Mike will show us how he did it. So first of all, we use data validation to make sure that someone chooses from this list. So I have a list of books up here, A1 to A3. All right, so that gets us our drop down. So the next thing I need to do is I need to add a comment to this cell. So we go to the reviewing ribbon, click new comment, and I'm going to get rid of all of the words. No words in that comment. Let's make the comment a little bit taller. We'll move it out a little bit so that way we can see it all the time. And now check this. I'm going to format that comment. I want to make sure that the comment is selected with dots and not diagonal lines. If you have the diagonal lines, it means you're editing text. We want to click on the diagonal lines to change them to dots. I'm going to press Control 1 for format, go to colors and lines, fill, and then fill effects. All right, so I can put a gradient there or a texture or a pattern or, oh, check this out, a picture. All right, so I have pictures of the three books. Click Insert, click OK, click OK. All right, check that out. Now we have a pop-up picture that appears over that cell. Sweet, isn't it? All right, now I'm going to right-click and say Show Hide Comment. That'll keep the comment always there. Your choice whether you want to do that or not. Okay, now, next we're going to do a little bit of code, a little bit of VBA code that says when this cell changes, we're going to change the picture attached to that comment. So I'm going to switch over to VBA with Alt F11. Usually code goes on its own module sheet, but not this time. This time we're going to go to the sheet where we want the magic to happen. So I'm here on sheet one. We would choose from the left drop-down worksheet, from the right drop-down change. So this is a little bit of code that's going to run every time that we run our, every time that a cell changes on this worksheet. Now I'm going to paste here. Control V, this is a code that I wrote before we started just to make sure that it's working. It says, hey, check and see if the target.address, the cell they just changed, is C6. Target is a variable that Excel is giving us. If it is, go find the name of the new picture. So it's this path, hard-coded, and then range C7. Oh, I didn't tell you about C7. Let's take a look there. Down here in C7, I have a little V lookup. The reason you can't see the V lookup is because I changed the font color to white. Let's change that back so you can see it. And that is actually getting file names from over here, so they were all hidden. Control Z, Control Z. All right, so, and then target, that's the cell we just changed, dot comment, dot shape, dot fill, user picture as a method, and we specify the new picture. So once we have that code in, choose a new value from the cell, it gets the new file name, loads the new picture, and it's a snap like that. All right, so that's my VBA solution. Putting a picture in a comment, using VBA to change the comment, even the data validation. You are going to find amazing tricks with Mike's method. I like Mike's method. I'm already giving him the point. So Mike, show us what you have.
Thanks, Mr. Excel. Hey, you're going to get the point and you're going to split it because this is not a trick I thought up by any means. MicroSuez from Malaysia actually sent in this link to exceltips.net. And this trick only works in 97, 2000, 2002, 3, not 2007. But it does work in 2010, which is what I'm using right here. So this trick does not work in 2007. And I've tried this trick a few times since MicroSuez sent this in, and it is a little buggy. You know, a couple times I did this trick and it didn't work, and I closed the workbook and opened it and it was working. So, buggy trick, but kind of interesting nonetheless. Now, point number one about this trick, you got to insert the pictures into the workbook, which means if you have 1,000 of them, switch to the VBA version. And secondly, when you insert the picture, it's got to be not inside the cell technically, but the cell's got to be sized so that the picture, the outside of the cell, is completely around the picture. Let's go ahead and insert a picture. Do this Bellin. This is a particular product in our lookup product table. Make it nice and small. All right, so we have our three pictures. And point number two is you have to name the cell, because we're going to use that name in a formula to get the picture to act as a lookup. So I want to name this Deuce, this Bellin, this Sunset. I already have the names in the cells to the left, so I highlight all the cells. And I'm going to use the keyboard shortcut Control-Shift-F3. Create names from selection. That name, or this cell, will be given that name. Click OK. Let's test it. I click there. Sure enough, I see Sunset. I arrow up. Bellin, arrow up, and I see Deuce. So the names are working. Now I want to do data validation. So I have a drop down here. I'm going to use my same trick, Control-Shift-F3, using the top row. So now this is named product. Click on that cell, Alt-DL, Tab-L, Tab, and I'm going to hit the F3 key to paste a name. F3 does not work everywhere. It does work in data validation, though. I'll paste the name. So now I have my drop down. And I have a VLOOKUP here, just looking up the price and the description. The last thing we need is our picture. We need any picture here, and then we'll put a formula inside the picture. Actually, before we do the picture, let's do the formula. We have a define name formula. Guess what? This is named Bellin. That's text. And this cell has a define name named Bellin. Well, our formula that's going to be inside the picture is going to look here, but that's text. And we really want it to look here. The indirect function can take text that represents a range and convert it to a range. To put the formula in define names, I'm going to use Control-F3, New. The name will be picture formula. How about that? And the formula will be down here. Equals, actually, it's already got the cell there, so I'll just put the indirect function. Open parentheses, close parentheses. I'm going to click OK, and I'm going to go ahead and test it. Click this collapse button right here. And sure enough, it's looking at the Bellin word and got converted to the range, and so it's highlighting it. That's a good trick when you're doing define names to click on that collapse button. Close. Last thing is we need our picture. Any picture will do, so I'm going to point to this one and hold Control, click and drag. Now I'm going to select the picture, come up to the formula bar, and type my name. F3 won't work here. I think it was picture, right? Picture formula, and then hit Enter. Now here's what I mean by buggy. That should be working right there. If I Control S and close this, and then go ahead and open it back up. Now, sure enough, look at that. If I click on this Bellin right here in the sunset, oh, look at that. Deuce, Bellin. I'm going to go ahead, because I did that named range right there and I have data validation, I can actually cut and paste this onto another sheet. Make sure that the picture is completely within all the cells you're cutting. Control-X, Control-V. And I can have my little product lookup here with the big picture. Select whatever I want here. Zoop. All right, I guess that's a three-way tie. VBA gets 0.5, and then excel.tips.net and Micro Suez from Malaysia each get a third of a point. All right, we'll see you next trick.
Mike, always great tips. Hitting minimize when we're defining the name to make sure that the thing is there. That is cool. And look at this boomerang. It is so lifelike on the screen. It's almost like I can reach out and grab it. Check that out. Hey, did you, for all of you watching, did you know that Mike was a five-time world record holder in the boomerangs? This is actually a boomerang that his company used to make, and now he is Excel is Fun. So hey, if you ever need a boomerang, check out Mike's boomerangs an amazing set of stuff. Now, Mike, I laughed when you said this doesn't work in Excel 2007. Yeah, that means that Excel 2007 is kind of like the Lost Lucy episodes. It's the only version of Excel that doesn't have a file menu and the only one where this trick doesn't work. But I'm a little bit confused because I got it to work in Excel 2007. I used a different method. I came up here and chose this cell, Control C, and then came down here and went to Paste as Picture, Paste Picture Link. And you see that there's a formula there. So I used your same trick of setting up a indirect my pick. Press enter. And now when we come here and change this to B3, that's my where my indirect is pointing, I get the other picture. So it is working in 2007 using basically the old camera tool. So we'll have to compare notes there. But anyway, so points all around and points to Mike for, you know, five-time world record holder. When I was a kid, I always wanted to be in the Guinness Book of World Records. Tried snatching quarters off my arm. I got within two of the record, and then some guy like did 65 instead of 39. So, Mike, I'm extremely jealous. A million points to you for having that world record. And hey, thanks to everyone for stopping by. See you next time for another Dueling Excel podcast from Mr. Excel, and Excel is fun. Excel.